Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Gary Jordan. Three residents of the International Space Station have safely returned to planet Earth. NASA astronaut Anne McLean, David Saint-Jacques of the Canadian Space Agency, and Oleg Kononenko of Roscosmos landed in the Kazakh steppe on Monday night U.S. time to complete a 204-day mission aboard the orbiting laboratory. Since launching December 3rd, the trio orbited the Earth 3,264 times, traveled well over 86 million miles, and worked on hundreds of scientific experiments in areas such as human biology, DNA editing, and 3D printing. Command of the International Space Station was handed over from Kononenko to Alexei Ovchinin, who will hold the position until he returns to Earth in October. The departing crew then said their farewells before closing the hatch and preparing for the 3-hour, 22-minute journey from undocking to touchdown. McLean and Saint-Jacques then returned to Houston, Texas, and Kononenko to Tsar City, Russia. When your friends are packing up for their trip home, do you ever say, "Hey, before I say goodbye, let me just sequence this DNA real fast"? No? I guess goodbyes are a bit different from the space station. Just a few hours before her crewmates departed the orbiting laboratory, NASA astronaut Christina Cook retrieved some samples from the station's freezer and sequenced DNA for the Genes in Space investigation. The DNA sequencer is a powerful tool on a small device that can identify complex biological structures. The tool was used for the Genes in Space 6 investigation, which looks at DNA damage and repair mechanisms in space. The sequencer helps to check the DNA after the repair process and look for any errors. This week's question comes from Heath, who asks how soon the crew is reunited with their families after landing. As you can imagine, it depends where your family is. Dan Hewitt answers this question during our live coverage of the crew's departure from the space station.
It actually differs for each of the crew members. So the crew will touch down, and then it's usually about 2 hours after landing until they're back at the staging airport in Kazakhstan. And then for Russian cosmonaut Oleg Kononenko, it's only a 4.5-hour flight back up to the Gagarin Cosmonaut Training Center. And for Anne and David, it'll be about 18.5 hours or so door-to-door from Kazakhstan back here in Houston. So it is pretty quick.
Keep sending in your questions to our live broadcasts and here on Space to Ground using the hashtag AskNASA. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.